worship service at Church of Our Savior in Fond du Lac.
And we begin our worship in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Most merciful God, we confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for us, and for his sake, God forgives us all our sins. As a called and ordained minister of the Church of Christ and by his authority, I therefore declare to you the entire forgiveness of all your sins and all our sins, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Please join us in the gathering.
Our bread, come from the wilderness and
the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Reading is taken from Isaiah chapter 55, verses 1 through 5. Ho, everyone who thirsts, come to the waters, and you that have no money, come, buy and eat. Come, buy wine and milk without money and without price. Why do you spend your money for that which is not bread, and your labor for that which does not satisfy? Listen carefully to me, and eat what is good, and delight yourselves in rich food. Incline your ear and come to me. Listen, so that you may live. I will make with you an everlasting covenant, my steadfast, sure love for David. See, I made him a witness to the peoples, a leader and commander to the peoples. See, you shall call nations that you do not know, and nations that do not know you shall run to you. Because of the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, he has glorified you. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Psalm 145. The Lord is gracious and full of compassion, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love. Lord, you are good to all, and your compassion is over all your works. The Lord upholds all those who fall, and lifts up those who are bowed down. The eyes of all wait upon you, O Lord, and you give them their food in due season. You open wide your hand and satisfy the desire of every living thing. You are righteous in all your ways and loving in all your works. You are near to all who call upon you, to all who call upon you faithfully. You fulfill the desire of those who fear you. You hear their cry and save them. You watch over all those who love you, but all the wicked you shall destroy. My mouth shall speak the praise of the Lord. Let all flesh bless God's holy name forever and ever.
The second reading is taken from Romans chapter 9, verses 1 through 5. I am speaking the truth in Christ. I am not lying. My conscience confirms it by the Holy Spirit. I have great sorrow and unceasing anguish in my heart. For I could wish that I myself were cursed and cut off from Christ for the sake of my own people, my kindred according to the flesh. They are Israelites, and to them belong the adoption, the glory, the covenants, the giving of the law, the worship, and the promises. To them belong the patriarchs, and from them, according to the flesh, comes the Messiah, who is over all, God blessed forever. Amen. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The Holy Gospel appointed to be read on this day from St. Matthew's Gospel, chapter 14. Glory to you, O Lord. Now when Jesus heard about the beheading of John the Baptist, he withdrew from there in a boat to a deserted place by himself. But when the crowds heard it, they followed him on foot from the towns. When he went ashore, he saw a great crowd, and he had compassion for them and cured their sick. When it was evening, the disciples came to him and said, "This is a deserted place, and the hour is now late. Send the crowds away so that they may go into the villages and buy food for themselves." Jesus said to them, "They need not go away. You give them something to eat." They replied, "We have nothing here but 5 loaves and 2 fish. And he said, "Bring them here to me." Then he ordered the crowds to sit down on the grass. Taking the 5 loaves and the 2 fish, he looked up to heaven and blessed and broke the loaves and gave them to the disciples. And the disciples gave them to the crowds, and all people ate and were filled. And they took up what was left over of the broken pieces, 12 baskets full. And those who ate were about 5,000 men, besides women and children. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. I begin the sermon in the name of Jesus, our Lord. Amen. He needed to get away. He was sad. John, his fellow spokesman for God, his friend, maybe cousin, had been beheaded by a King Herod, known to be a conniver, a liar, a brute, and a ruthless king. What kind of person orders the beheading of another human being? Who does that? In the face of that, Jesus needed to get away. He needed to be in the wilderness, far away from things and people. He needed to think, to grieve, to reflect. But the people followed him. Human need is like that. The people needed his wisdom, his intellect, his reliance on things of the Spirit of God. They needed that now. They needed his compassion. So they went out there in the wilderness where Jesus was. And now it was late in the day. It was evening, and they were in a deserted place. The people were hungry, not starving, just hungry. Some wanted to send the people home or into nearby villages so they could get food for themselves. Jesus resisted. "Sit down," the people were told. They sat down on the grass. It was springtime, close to Passover. The grass was green and lush, and the people sat in orderly arrangements like flowers in a flower bed, the original Greek text tells us. The disciples passed out food to all 5,000 people. Each disciple, according to my calculations, must have served food to over 450 people. A big job, but maybe they got help. The men, according to Matthew, were counted, not the women, not people about to be married, not boyfriends, not girlfriends, not children, just men. So was the number bigger than 5,000? Another gospel tells us it was 4,000, but how are we to know? The people out there in the wilderness with Jesus and his disciples weren't starving. They weren't dying. We know what that looks like. We've seen the pictures of refugee camps all over our world where food is scarce. We've seen the long lines of cars in places around our country during this pandemic, stretching for miles, waiting for hours for boxes of food. We've heard of young students unable to concentrate in classrooms because they are too hungry. We've heard of malnutrition and what it does to people. We've heard of those health issues. Every living thing needs food to survive. My wife and I work one day each month preparing and serving food for people, mostly black people, in the inner city of Milwaukee. And each time we come away from that experience, we have a lot to talk about. We sometimes feel it is such a small thing that we do, such a drop in the bucket. But then there are other times when we have meetups with people there, and it's worthwhile. It feels good. The details leading up to and surrounding the feeding of the 5,000 people plus are striking. There was great sadness in Jesus' life. We know that. The people came in large numbers to be with him. We know that too. Even out there in the wilderness, what Jesus said and did was so helpful to them. But Jesus was sad, so sad, and his heart was heavy. But the people needed him too. That's one of the realities of life. They wanted to see him and hear his words. They needed him. They needed his sympathy, his compassion, his mercy, his understanding. So they tracked him down. To repeat, human need is like that. You know how that is, I'm sure. I know how that is. We've been called to the bedside of a loved one in the middle of the night. We've all had to drop what we were doing because of emergency. We've all stopped along highways to help those in trouble. We've all heard the pitiful cries of people, young and old, in excruciating pain. We've made fast trips, unscheduled, to emergency rooms. We've held the hands of others tight. We've held glasses of cool water for those wanting to take a sip. And we've been at the bedside of those dying. There is no convenient time. Human need does not happen neatly. Human need is usually inconvenient. It happens often at the wrong time. It interrupts. But we believe, because of our faith in God, that no one should ever suffer alone. No one, to add to that thought, should ever die alone. No one should ever starve to death. We believe that. Everyone should eat. Jesus' compassion for the people, in spite of his own personal sadness, came through that day when he took 5 loaves of bread, 2 fish, blessed them like we bless Holy Communion, and fed the people. The needs of the people took priority. They came first. Each of the 4 Gospels tells the story of the feeding of 5,000 or 4,000 people out there in the wilderness. But it is the Gospel of John alone that tells us about that young boy who showed up with 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish, which he gave to Jesus. Jesus blessed the bread, to repeat, like we bless the bread at Holy Communion. He blessed the fish, he broke the bread, and he gave both bread and fish to his disciples to be passed out to the crowd. No one was left out. No one was passed by. No one was excluded. Everyone was fed. And 12 baskets of leftover food were gathered up. People, all people, should eat. There's a lesson here for us and for our churches. Never get into the way of the Lord. That's the first lesson. We are not in control. We do not own the Word of God or the sacraments, Holy Baptism and Holy Communion, or anything else in this world, really. We own none of that. The Lord owns it. It belongs to Him. So we share, and we share freely. We share gladly, And that when it comes to God and what God does among us humans, we celebrate the message of God's word and we share the Holy Communion because it serves and feeds all people as it is meant to do. People young and old, people we know, people we do not know, they are all fed. People who come into this church and are never seen again, they are fed. Let me repeat, we do not own either the word or the sacraments. God does. No one should ever die of starvation. No one should ever be turned away from what God gives. No one wanting God's mercy and love should ever be passed by, not at Holy Communion, not anywhere. I've heard too many of those stories of people in deep human need who went to church on a given Sunday morning because they needed the presence of God. They needed the healing that God gives. And as they knelt at a communion rail, they were passed by because the pastor did not know them. How tragic. There is more than enough hospitality to heal the divisions and issues of estrangement in all our world. There is more than enough hope to restore the world's despair. There is more than enough wisdom to address the deepest of our culture's challenges. There is more than enough compassion to mend the broken hearts in our land and in all lands. There is more than enough mercy in our world to go around. There may be limited resources. Jesus only had 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish, but Jesus made them work. Jesus takes a meager supply, a limited supply of food. He blesses it, and he puts it into the hands of those who follow him, people like us, and we give what has first been given to us to others. And we praise God because he is the one who gives, and those who are hungry in body and soul are fed. Amen. Praise him.
Let us confess together our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven, and he is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and a life everlasting. Amen.
We pray the prayer of intercession. Let us pray. Confident of your care and help by the Holy Spirit, we pray for the Church, the world, and all who are in need. You take resources that appear to be meager. You bless them, and then there is enough. May your church trust that what you bless and ask us to share with the world is abundantly sufficient. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Your bountiful creation offers sustenance and life for all creatures. Protect this abundance for the well-being of all. Reverse the damage we have caused your creation. Replenish groundwater supplies. Provide needed rains in places of drought, and protect forests from wildflower fires. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You offer yourself to all the nations and the peoples of the earth, inviting everyone to be and to receive the abundant life. Bring the prophetic vision to fullness, that all nations will run to you, and that all nations who do not know you will find their joy in you. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You open your hand and satisfy the desire of every living thing. Heal the anguish of tender hearts who cry to you in suffering and satisfy their deepest needs. Bring wholeness and healing to those who suffer in body, heart, soul, and mind, especially Sheila, Norma, Jean, Barb, Nancy, Larry, Brian, Ted, Fran, Bobby, Danielle, Rachel, Troy, Fran, Robin, Valeska, Carol, Renee, Sandy, Duffy, Sherry, Brad, Fran, Carson, Don, Jan, Doug, Gilbert, Wendy, Jeff, Kay, Christina, Diana, Leo, Deanna, Nancy, Linda, Paula. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You offer freely the fullness of salvation. Give our congregation, this congregation, such a welcoming heart that our words and actions may extend your free and abundant hospitality to all whom we encounter. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God, our peace and our strength, we pray for our nation and the world as we face uncertainties around the coronavirus. Protect the most vulnerable among us, especially all who are sick or are in isolation. Grant wisdom, patience, clarity to health care workers, especially as they work caring for others, that caring that puts them at great risk. Guide us as we consider how best to respond in our families, congregations, workplaces, and communities. Give us courage to face these days not with fear, but with compassion, concern, and acts of service, trusting that you abide with us always. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You gather your saints as one, united in the body of Jesus. Bring us with all your saints to the heavenly banquet. We remember with love and thanksgiving the saints we have known. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. In the certain hope that nothing can separate us from your love, we offer these prayers to you through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Let us pray as Christ taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Receive the blessing. Neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus. God the Creator, Jesus the Christ, and the Holy Spirit the Comforter bless you and keep you in eternal love. Amen.
Please join in singing the Sending Hymn.
Praise the Lord.
us today. And thank you for your continued financial support of the ministries of Church of Our Savior. Your generosity is much appreciated and needed to continue those ministries of the Church. Offerings made by check may be mailed to Church of Our Savior, 363 South Main Street, Fond du Lac, 54935. Or you may take advantage of online giving options available on the website, oursaviorsfdl.org. Go in peace. Christ is with you. Thanks be to God.